Hello, Practical Class and Master Class members. I will talk about needle control while using the two-handed technique. Take a look at this ultrasound probe. Then, I will explain the details of the markers. There's a marker here. And then here's another one. And then here's another marker. It is the indicator marker. This marker indicates the direction of the probe. When this probe's marker is pointed toward the patient's head, the corresponding marker on the ultrasound screen is usually displayed on the left. The midline is the linear array of the pixels of the sound generation and image sensors, and the whole length becomes the width of the ultrasound image. So, the needle should go in like this or like this. Next, I will explain the needles. They are the lists of the needle that I commonly use in my clinical practices. Join our Masterclass membership today and unlock a treasure trove of knowledge. Benefit from twice-weekly videos, including inspiring lectures, clinical case discussions, and image interpretation insights. Elevate your skills and connect with like-minded doctors. Subscribe now for a brighter professional future. 0.5 inches, then 1 inch, then 1.5 and 2 inches. It becomes a 9 centimeters needle. Let me repeat it. 0.5 inch 26 gauge, 1 inch 26 gauge, 1.5 inch 25 gauge, 25 gauge 2 inches. The next one is the 25 gauge 9 centimeters spinal needle, which is more stiff and has a stylet. The 1.5 inch needle is the needle that I use the most. When inserting the needle under ultrasound guidance, you must align it with the midline. This is because the needle can be visualized only with the midline aligned, whether the needle to footplate distance is close or far. I will explain the needle insertion process under an ultrasound probe. While you put the ultrasound probe on the body's surface, imaging the cloth's thickness is the object's depth. Let me explain the skin puncture point on the in-plane approach. You can insert it here or like this, a little further. The movement direction of the needle is like this, shallow or steep like this. It depends on the depth of the target. And when you want it to be very close, lift the ultrasound probe at the insertional needle area and cautiously insert the needle without touching the probe. After putting the needle under the skin, check the image. You can choose smaller ones if you want to make a target at a close and superficial object. Try to put the needle close to the edge of the footprint. Let me try with a 1-inch needle, and it's a bit longer but still smaller. Usually, you need to bring the needle very close to the ultrasound probe. So it would be best if you were careful with that because it increases the risk of contamination or puncturing the ultrasound probe condom. It is a 1.5 inch needle, and I use it in the shoulder, elbow, knee, ankle joints, and nerves. It may be the most commonly used needle. Also, I mostly approach the needle in plane technique and carefully watch the probe's edge. I can put the needle at a steep or flat angle. Next, the 2-inch long needle. It is for the quite deeper object. You are allowed to go further away since there's enough distance. I use it for the posterior knee, targeting the posterior fat pad triangle for the pain relief arising from the posterior root tear of the medial meniscus and cruciate ligament, and shoulder, targeting the inferior joint capsule in case of adhesive capsulitis. I will explain the out-of-plane technique and needle. When doing the out-of-plane technique, first, you must watch the midpoint of the ultrasound probe. Mostly the company provides the midline marker for the midline of the ultrasound probe. Find the midline marker and puncture the skin to the extension line of the center of this line, like this. You insert it tangentially and advance the needle by a variable insertional angle. But, it is challenging to calculate the needle depth in this out-of-plane technique under the area of the ultrasound probe. So, you have to control the needle angle by simultaneously watching the needle on the screen and keeping change the needle angle. The in-plane needle approach of puncturing the skin at the side of the object is sometimes needed with a short-axis scan of the target object. It is an example of needle insertion for the plantar fasciitis of the posterior heel. In this case, you have to calculate the depth of the target and put the needle transversely, aligning the needle with the ultrasound beam, in addition to putting the needle aligned to the midline indicator of the posterior edge of the footprint. I want to talk about one more technical aspect of needle advancement. Usually, we may imagine the needle would move straight forward to our directed vector. But the needle could not move straight, actually. It is true if you use the needle large bore needle. But I prefer a smaller diameter needle with optimal flexibility because it causes less damage and provokes less pain. The bending of the needle during advancement is happening anytime. For example, if you apply too much force for the advancement, and the needle tip meets a stiff interface, it will torque the needle force to bend and be out of sight because of the misalignment of the needle to the ultrasound beam. So, please push the needle gently and very slowly. It would be best if you rode the wave of the soft tissue. If you do it too much like this, then the needle won't be visible, so it would help if you looked at the monitor and then the needle, always checking the needle and monitor. For the ultrasound-guided procedure of fingers, select a small short needle with an out-of-plane approach and insert it like this. The finger is round in real situations, so it is a more realistic demonstration. Find the joint gas with the ultrasound scan, align the probe to the finger's long axis, and put the midline indicator in the joint line. Putting the needle along the joint line with an in-plane approach is nearly impossible. Hold the probe like this and insert the needle like this. How about the elbow and cervical nerve root? I use 1.5-inch longer needle. Sometimes, I put the skin close to the probe's edge, but I put the needle posterior to the line of the footprint of the probe and advance the needle. So, it will take time and space between needle insertion and the needle tip's first visualization. Next is the long spinal needle. I always use the needle in deep targets such as the hip joint. It is more flexible and easily bend because of its long length. So, visualizing the needle is difficult because of its frequent bending, deep soft structure, and small caliber needle. Watch the needle bending. The needle frequently bends. The best solution to prevent the bend of the needle is to decrease the tissue's resistance, which can get from weak, gentle pressure and slow advancement. Thank you for watching this tutorial. I hope you found it helpful, and I look forward to sharing more valuable content with you in our upcoming videos.